Did you forget what you were doing?
Did I forget what I was doing? Did you forget that it was important to set up a forget password set up inside of Softr? There was a lot of forgetting that I just said, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna dive into the ways that you can set up configuring forget password and reset the password inside of Softr. It's actually really easy to set up. Let's jump right into it. So say, for example, we were to dive into an employee directory. A perfect example of how this can be set up is in what I have currently. So you can actually configure this placeholder text like I have for the logins. So pressing this, you can see that I have placeholder text that utilizes the magic links within Softr in order to sign in to this account. In the same way, I could incorporate that same placeholder text by having it so that it would go to a page that would then allow the user to forget the password via clicking on it and going to a page that would forget that password with that block. So I press forget password, so you can see I'm going to a page that has a block that allows me to recover and do a reset password. How did I set this up? Let's show you how. So first and foremost, by clicking on this, you can see I'm using a sign-in form. So let's press add block here and create a new sign-in form. If we see on this sign-in form, there's also an option for forgot password. So if I click on this and undo it, you'll see that'll disappeared. Now, what this needs to do, similar to this other one, is press add action, and then we need to go to open page, and then we select the forget password page. So for example, this forget password page, then once we go to it, it's gonna have exactly what's needed. So here we have a forget password form. When we scroll down, we can see that this action button for recover password has the action of recover password. And then it has the confirmation message associated to that. So by pressing this plus icon here, I'm gonna then create a forget, type in password, and then we have a forget and a reset password form. By putting this forgot password, see that it gives a action item to recover the password. And what this will do is once the person puts in their email, it will then send them an email to reset the password. So let's test this out in theory. We're gonna go to publish updates, preview the actual website. Then I'm gonna go to this reset password page, type in my email here. So Demetri@softr.io, press recover password. And then I'm gonna get a link sent to my email. If I go to it and click on this, and you'll see that there is a reset password token. And you can clearly see that there's an option to essentially just ignore it if you didn't mean to do it on purpose. But by clicking this, this would reset the password. And I can type in this new password. So what do I want to reset it to? That's for me to know, and you did not. So then after typing in the password, I would put reset. And then from here, I will do an actual login to prove that it worked. And then when I press sign in, you'll see that I got let in because I know what I'm doing, evidently. Now, once again, there is a secondary option to this. So by going to this forget password page, we're also going to create the other form, which is a form by the name of reset password. Because as you saw, it did end up sending me to that. So with this, you'll notice that this recover password has a action that sends to the recover password. So by going to the reset password page, you see that this is exactly what it was then mapped to in the example that I just went through. So how did I create that? All I need to do is add a block called reset password form, press plus, and then from there, simple as day, just same exact system. We have a very smart app. Is that clear? It's not actually that complicated to set this up. It's a very simple workflow. And by following the things that have the proper action buttons and having a page essentially for sign in, forget password, reset password, we're pretty much good to go. Now you do just want to make sure that these are set up, because if you don't, people might freak out. People might get a little bit concerned and be like, I don't know how to access Softr, and that's a problem. I really like using it. We don't want that. So make sure you go through the process of using forget password on your original text for your sign in, and then setting up a forget password page and a reset password page with respective blocks. And don't forget to check out all of our other amazing videos on Softr and how to improve your skills using Softr even more. Thanks for watching.